today I'm going to talk to you about something very basic, which is related to a mental health field, is stress, demotivation and test anxiety, जो आजकल हर students में होता है mostly. So when we talk about mental health, what is the first picture that comes to our head? Anyone, if you guys want to answer. Okay, too much social pressure, I guess. So when we say mental health, normally in India, people generally think about things like taking medication or being in mental asylum or things like abnormal behavior. But mental health is not only about abnormal behavior. There is more attached to it, something very basic, which is stress, जिसके ऊपर पूरी mental health is based. So in India, the problem with mental health is that we don't acknowledge it or we stigmatize it too much. There are times when like there are basic problems in our life. When we don't accept or acknowledge it, builds into stress, causing a lot of mental disorders. Till the time we get to know that हमें कोई problem है, तब तक already बात हाथ से निकल चुकी होती है, जैसे हम बोलते हैं, and we go to something known as something, some kinds of typical behavior. So firstly, I'll give you an example जो हमारी day to day life में होता है stress का, very basic example which every woman I would say go through in their life, is what should we cook for our children. So a very personal example, like my mom will come to me every day and will ask me कि खाने में क्या बनाना है for lunch and dinner. So for us it's like a very usual practice कि कुछ भी बना दो, ये कर दो, वो कर दो types. But when they are in kitchen and thinking what should they make for us, whether they will like it or not, or other questions related to it, this causes a lot of stress in them, which normally for us is a normal habit, but for them is a stressful process. So it's like every single day they are going through something which is so stressful, and they acknowledge, or we acknowledge this as love in the name of stress, which is wrong. So that is one basic example which I can give you, which is related to stress. So there are certain physical manifestations of stress which we face on day-to-day basis, but we don't acknowledge. So let's start with when we are giving an exam, what happens? We don't see that our shoulders are very tired, they are tensed, our teeth is clenched, or our hands are sweaty. Our heartbeat is fast. What is all of this? This is stress. This shows that we are in a stressful situation and our mind is reacting to it. So these are certain things which we feel when we are stressed out. So now I'll tell you in a very basic language what stress is. Stress is nothing but a feeling of abnormal pressure that we face on the daily basis. So there are certain symptoms or signs that we can say of stress. First is a feeling of this constant tension in our body, like our palms are sweaty, our muscles are tight. Then the second thing is we are not able to concentrate in anything. Like agar hum basic kaam bhi kar rahe hoge, we wouldn't be concentrating on it or can't focus on it. Especially students who are extremely stressed out, for them having issues in concentration is a huge deal. Because if you're not concentrated on something, you will not be able to perform well. Then there is difficulty relaxing. Apart from that, there is snapping a lot. When you are stressed out, you will notice that you snap a lot. Like छोटी छोटी बातों पे गुस्सा आ जाएगा, बहुत जल्दी जल्दी मूड स्विंग्स होंगे. ये सब एक स्ट्रेस के सिम्टम्स हैं that we should actually acknowledge. So this is what is stress. So before I go on to how we manage this, do we have any questions or anything you guys want to say about stress? Just drop me a message in chat box if you're uncomfortable talking on large platform. It's completely fine.
So, hello. Good evening, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yeah, you are.
Okay. So, ma'am, I just wanted to quote that, once we start our, corporate journey and once we start, working, ma'am, stress is the thing that automatically we carry with ourselves. So, like, it's not like we cannot, you know, like we cannot deny the fact that, you know, once we start our journey into a corporate or, you know, once we start working. So this is one thing, ma'am, we cannot deny it, or we cannot, you know, get rid of.
True, I agree. Stress is something you should acknowledge, but there are ways to manage stress. See, it's like, agar aap daily basis pe stressed out rahoge, there will be a point where your mind will actually give up on the work you are doing, which will lead to procrastination a lot. So yes, you cannot deny stress, you cannot get away from it, but definitely you can manage it. So let's come to that part of management. So there are three basic factors that we look into when we talk about managing stress. First is action-oriented approach. Now, what is action-oriented approach? Over there, what you do is you recognize there is something stressful in your life, or there is a situation that is causing you stress, and then you take an action which is appropriate to solve that particular thing, in which comes problem solving and time management. This is the first way. Second is emotion-oriented approach. So what happens is, most of the time, if there is a situation, we perceive it in a certain way, right? We see something, we understand something, we find a meaning to it, and then we react emotionally to it. So sometimes maybe our perception about it is faulty in itself and causing us stress. So we can change the way we are seeing that situation, which will help us to control us particular moment pe apna stress and then think it through. So for instance, the best way of doing this is distancing yourself from the problem itself. So like if you are stressed out on a particular situation, take some time out, give yourself 10 minutes to react, think about it, and then react. So in that 10 minutes, you will be able to find a solution to it, as well as understand what is the reason why it is stressing you out. Then the last approach is acceptance-oriented approach, which is, I would say, the basics of understanding and coping with it. So you have a problem, but most of the times as humans, what we do is we tend to ignore it, or we tend to live in a very wishful thinking ki, okay, this is what it is, but no, in my head, this is what it is like. So that gap of this is what it is and what it is like in our head shows that we're not accepting the problem. So till the time you don't accept something, we cannot find a solution to it. So these are the three basic ways of coping with or managing your stress. So now there are certain tips I will give you, which we can use in our day-to-day life for this. First is positive self-talk. The way we talk to ourselves is really, really, really important. So I'll give you an example for this. Suppose there's a student who is sitting for an exam. Let's say civil services. Civil services is in India has created this huge pressure on students, where when they're sitting for an exam, they are so negative. What they are saying to themselves is that humne padhai nahi ki hai itni ki hum ye exam crack kar paye, ya fir we are not sufficient enough to crack this exam, or this is too difficult for us. So what we are feeding to ourselves is all negative thoughts. The more you are negative about something, aapki body waisi react karegi. Jab aapki body ek particular stress se jayegi, to your mind will shut off. अपने आप ही ऑटोमैटिकली यू विल नॉट रिमेंबर व्हाट यू हैव स्टडीड. सो व्हाट यू आर फीडिंग टू योरसेल्फ इज एक्सट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टेंट. अनदर एग्जांपल दैट आई कैन गिव यू इज फ्रॉम माय वेरी पर्सनल व्यू पॉइंट इज सोशल एंजाइटी. सो आई हैव सोशल एंजाइटी. व्हेन आई एम ऑन स्टेज और आई हैव टू स्पीक समथिंग, अर्लियर आई यूज टू फीड थिंग्स टू माई सेल्फ दैट आई कैन नॉट डू दिस. There are too many people. I will be blank when I will speak, or I will get nauseous. I cannot do this. I used to do that a lot. And eventually, whenever I had to give presentations or give public appearances, I used to get really scared, go blank, don't know what to say. And it did affect a lot of things in my life. But if I tell myself before starting this, no, I can do this. I am prepared enough. I am confident enough. This is positive self-talk. It will boost my confidence and my motivation to do something. This is the first thing. Second, is something which our parents always tell us to do, but we as teenagers or we as youngsters ignore is exercise. Exercising is really important. It helps to release happy hormones in our body. More the happy hormones in your body, more active your mind will be to cope up with things. Then is eating healthy food. It is really important what you eat. So if you are having a lot of junk food, there are so many studies published which has said that more junk food you consume, your mind will become lazier. So our aim is not to make our mind lazy. Our aim is to make our mind active. So junk food is not a way to make ourselves active. Then resting. Resting is really important. Proper 7 to 8 hours of sleep in our age group is really important, and we should consider that, because these days, because of COVID, lockdown, and things like that, people sleep by 3 in the morning, wake up at 12 in the afternoon. This is a very bad habit. It is going to create a lot of issues for you. Then the thing is, be aware about your triggers. What is triggering you? What is causing that stress? If you don't know that, you will not be able to cope up with this. It will keep on building, and there will be a point where your body will be exhausted and you will just snap on each and every person around you. This is very subjective. Obviously, it depends from person to person. But once your body is exhausted, you have no idea what stress can cause. It can lead to depression. It can lead to anxiety. It can lead to other mental health issues. So be aware of what is triggering you. Even if, suppose you are working in an office and your work atmosphere is toxic, acknowledge it, talk to someone about it, do something about it, but just don't live in it, because this is going to create long-term effects on you, which wouldn't be very healthy. Then music. Everyone loves to hear music. Whenever you are stressed out or tensed, try listening to something that is calming. Try listening to something that makes you feel good about things, or maybe dance it out. So if you dance, your body is active. Once your body is active, it will help you to release a lot of happy hormones, and you will definitely feel better. Lastly, it is, what will you tell your friends? Which is very important, because we as humans have a tendency to be very hard on ourselves, that we have a habit of self-blaming. Ki sab hamari galti hai. Hum ye nahi dekhte us particular situation mein maybe samne wala galat ho. So very common example that I'm going to give you over here is about relationships. So what happens is, if a person cheats on you, then what do? We tell ourselves ki nahi, hamari galti hai. We were not enough, or we were not providing that person with enough care, love and support. That is why that person cheated on us, which is not really true. Because if your friend will come with the same problem, what will you tell them? That no, it's not true. You are enough. He doesn't value you, or she doesn't value you. So this is how things work. If you are giving an exam or in any situation where you're feeling as if things are going out of your hands, take a minute, think about it. Think if your best friend will come to you with the same problem. In that case, what will you do? This will definitely help you. Now, some coping mechanisms that I will tell you, these are the basic tips. Now, coping mechanisms. So there are two kinds of coping mechanism. One is healthy, one is unhealthy. So unhealthy would be numbing, which is where some stress comes and you go blank. You are numb. You are not able to feel anything. You try to get away from it. This is unhealthy. Instead of this, what we can try is that go for running, which is a healthier option. So this is all about stress and how you can cope up with it. So before I start with my second topic on test anxiety, is there anything anyone wants to add or discuss? Anyone? Okay, so let's talk about test anxiety. So what is exactly test anxiety? When we are giving an exam, before giving an exam, we receive a paper. We go through it and we start panicking. And we are like, we will not be able to clear this. This is it. This is where I will fail. And then from there, the downward spiral starts. We get anxious. We get nauseous. We go blank. And that's how we ruin our paper. Even a very simple question which you have studied throughout a year, you will not be able to solve it, because in that moment, you will be completely anxious. So there are two realistic fears that is associated with the test anxiety. I think most of you, when we sit for exam, what we do is we think that we are not ready for the test, that we cannot do this, we cannot clear this. This is one of the basic fear which we as humans have. But in that moment, instead of thinking that we are not ready for it, just remind yourself the amount of hard work you have put into it throughout a month, throughout the year. Just remind that. The more you'll remind yourself that you are prepared, the better you will perform. Second thing which we associate our exam with is a self-worth. That if we fail, this is it. This is how my life will end. No one will respect me. Honestly, this is not true. One exam is not going to determine how intelligent or how worthy you are. This is just an exam. Your life is more about exams. Your life is more to it. So it's better to tell yourself that no, it is okay. It's just an exam. We have other options too. Just don't be completely dependent on one exam, because this will cause a lot of self-esteem issues, and clearly we don't need them when we are giving an exam. The third fear which we have is that our family members or our teachers or our colleagues will think that we are stupid. We cannot clear this exam. Clearly, their opinion doesn't matter, to be very honest, because you know where you stand. You know what you are worth. So what they think is not really relevant for us, because it's very subjective. If a person may think, your parents will always think that you're extremely intelligent, no matter how many exams you fail, no matter how many exams you clear, they will still have a same opinion about you, that you are intelligent. On the other hand, someone who's jealous of you, no much how much you will achieve, no matter how much you will do, still they will think of you as stupid. So clearly their opinion is not something you can rely on. It's better to rely on yourself. So this is what is test anxiety and fears related to it. Anyone has a question about test anxiety before I can start with how we can manage this? Please make it a little interactive. I don't want it to be a monologue sort of a thing.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I have a question. Ma'am, yeah. When we talk about test anxiety, ma'am, don't you think so it gets like, it starts from our home also, like when we have, when we don't have, you know, that positive environment in our home, you know, like maybe our parents, they start, you know, they just start, you know, comparing ourselves with, you know, with some other people. So I think that, you know, at home also it can be the reason.
True, I agree. Indian parents have a habit of comparing a lot. That is true, I agree. But the thing is that, see, you cannot tell your parents that, you know, that we are doing our best, still it's not happening, because no matter what you do, they will compare you. But in that case, you really need to talk to your parents and explain them, which generally doesn't work that much considering Indian scenario and how Indian parents are. So rather than explaining them this thing, be really assured and be very confident about yourself. Because most of the times when we are sitting for an exam and we remember that, oh, mere parents ne mujhe unke bachcho ya dusre bachcho se compare kiya tha, par unhone exam clear kar liya, what if main nahi kar paun to? So in that case, in any case, tumne jo padha hoga, you will not remember and you are definitely going to screw your paper. So yes, there are ways of dealing with this, but you have to deal with it. Otherwise, you ask your parents or you go for counseling, to be very honest, because that is something that needs to be changed in India right now. Does it help, Smriti? Okay. So
yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So let's talk about how we can manage a test anxiety. First thing is systematically studying. We need to study every day. If our exam is next year from now, we start a month before and you expect to clear it, I'm sorry to say that it will not help you. No matter how good you are at it, no matter how many hours you are putting in it, there is something known as being consistent with your studies. It is really important. The more hard work you will do on the daily basis is going to boost your confidence. So don't keep your studies for the last moment. It is not going to help you. First thing. Second is studying in familiar places. So our brain has this habit where you have to make certain environment, create certain environment, no matter wherever you are studying. So your brain is familiar with that place. For instance, every day, if you study in one particular place, your brain will be able to learn more and give more. It's not that aaj aap ek room mein pad rahe ho, dusre din aap dusre room mein pad rahe ho, teesre din aap kahin aur pad rahe ho. Your brain needs to have a habit. This habit will be formed when you are doing one thing in one particular place at each and every day at a particular time period. It is really important to study in a familiar place. Third is pre-test routine. So I'm sure all of you guys give mock exams a lot. If not mock exams, you practice for your exam. So what happens these days? It's online, but I'll be telling in a very general context, whether it's offline or online. When you practice for an exam, make sure that there is a certain habit you follow. Like, for instance, what I do is if I'm practicing for an exam or I'm going to give an exam, first step for me is to listen to something that suits me. I will listen to some Bollywood musical songs, which are like very peppy so that my mind is calm. It is subjective. You guys can listen to instrumental music also. That helps. Second thing I do is I take off my watch, keep it on the right side of the table and then look at it, keep my pens on the left side and then start my exam. So this, even if I'm practicing tests at home, this is what I do. Listen to music, keeping my watch on one side, keeping my pens on one side and then starting it. So before, whenever you are doing this, your brain is prepared to jo exam ke time mein ek sudden shock aata hai ki ye nahi aata, wo nahi aata hai, ya fir we are not able to perform, we will not be able to go through this, wo kam ho jayega because your brain is somewhere prepared to give an exam already. Then if you are facing problems in understanding material or not able to perform well, talk to your teachers, talk to your supervisors, talk to your family members, tell them where you are lacking so that they can help you. So on the date of exam, you are well prepared for it and not having second opinions or doubt whether you want to go ahead with it. Then something very important you can try is relaxation exercises. I will only focus on one because it is not at all time consuming. Paper ke beech maybe you can use it, paper ke starting maybe you can use it, or any time of the day where you're feeling really stressed out or your mind is not functioning, you can do this. This is normal breathing exercise where you will inhale for 4 seconds, keep it for 7 seconds and then exhale for 8 seconds. So this is known as 4-7-8, really helpful. It will help you to relax. It will help you to make your mind calm. Try it before exam, after exam, during exam. It hardly takes 2 minutes. Then what you eat is important. So before exam, make sure that you eat like a good amount of healthy food. Don't eat burgers or french fries before exam. Your mind will go lazy. Your mind will start forgetting things, which exactly we don't want. Exercise and sleep is also very important before exam. So make sure that you do it. So this is all about test anxiety and how we can cope up with this. Now I will talk about demotivation, which is very common these days. So before demotivation, can anyone wants to share anything about it? Or how demotivation has affected you in past few months or in your exams? Okay, so something about demotivation is it is common. Every person goes through it. There is a day or there is a week in our life or in a month where we are like, ab nahi karna, let's give up on this. Nahi hoga. Ab ye karna nahi, not possible. This is not something we want to do. Let's change. Let's go for something simple. This is what is demotivation. And when we start thinking about ki ab nahi karna, nahi hoga. What is this? This is nothing but just your negative self-talk. So how do we manage this particular problem of demotivation? First thing is to acknowledge that yes, you are demotivated. Just don't give excuses for it. Ki nahi, today is not the day. Today I'm just lazy. Please don't give your mind unnecessary excuses about this because this is not going to help. More you acknowledge it, more your mind will know that your mind is demotivated and would do something about it, which is really important. So before we start doing our work, which is or study or office work or any work, take a piece of paper, take a pen, write everything down that is going on in your head. Like even a smallest thing, like I have to make this for lunch, I have to make this for dinner. Two, ab mujhe nahi karne ka man hai, ya fir any other personal issues you are going through. You had a fight with your family members, you had a fight in a relationship. Just write everything down in that piece of paper before you start working. You really need to declutter your mind before you start working, because if you study or if you work with stress in your head coming from anywhere, believe me, you will be demotivated throughout the work. You will not give your 100%. In the end, you will not be satisfied with your work, which will cause you a lot of emotional disturbances. First thing is that. Second thing is, we tend to run away from our work. We tend to run away from our education. We have to study a chapter and it is really boring. What we'll do is we'll just run away from it. We'll do it tomorrow, we'll do it abhi nahi, we'll do it kabhi aur. But this is not really helping, because eventually you will realize the more time you take to start something, it will cause you more frustration as compared to you finishing it first. So make sure that you don't run away from it. Then the third thing is, we blame ourselves a lot that this is our fault. We are too lazy. We cannot do it. We are stupid. We shouldn't do it. So when this comes, the habit of blaming ourselves, we are so busy blaming ourselves that we actually don't take a step ahead in working or working through it. Now, again, if you see, this is wrong. Blaming yourself is negative self-talk and causing you demotivation. Ultimately, in the end, it's not helping you. So whenever you are going through this negative cycle of blame and self-talk, just think about it and think, how is this going to help you? Is it adding something to your life or something to the work you have to do? Or is it just wasting your time? And even if you really want to indulge in that negative self-talk, take like 5 minutes out of your daily schedule. Think about the habits or think about the things that you think is negative about you, and then find a solution to it rather than just thinking ki nahi ye mere saath problem hai to main aisa nahi karu. Aisa nahi hota hai. Normally aisa nahi hota. There's a solution to everything, but we are so busy focusing on our problems that the solution we want, we never get it. Then comes, try to understand your style of working. So for instance, there are people who like to wake up early, finish their work, then start their day. Then there are people who cannot concentrate in morning. Like me, I cannot concentrate in morning. I need to study at night. If I'm studying in morning, I'll be the most demotivated. I will not even give my 10% to that work. But when I'm doing it at night, I'll be more focused. I'll do it in a better way. I'll prepare better material, or I'll be able to understand my client's problems easily or what I have done throughout the day. So you know what is better for you. Try studying in that way. Make a schedule which is better for you. Not ki samne wala din mein 4 ghante pad raha hai, to mujhe bhi 4 ghante padna hai. Maybe that 4 hours that the person is taking is his style. But in your case, even if you'll study for 2 hours, it's more than enough for you. It totally depends upon you. So stop comparing as to how the person is doing, how the other person is doing. Make an approach which is better for you. Then don't ever question your abilities. Today, if you are having a lazy day, don't be like, I cannot do it in future also, because this is not how it is. If today you're not able to do something, maybe it's just a bad day for you, but tomorrow you will be able to do it. So one day will not decide how capable you are. The amount of work that you put on everyday basis will decide how capable you are. So let's not just give one day that leverage of breaking us down. Now, the other thing that you can do is you can imagine you starting from somewhere. So I don't know how many of you from in this session are preparing for 5 years law exam. From there, I will tell you. So contracts is one of the topics which we have in legal aptitude. What happens is, it is really boring. I know that it is extremely boring. This is something of the least interest. for people. So that is why we never start it. We are like, aaj nahi, kal nahi. And ultimately, our exam comes and we are like, oh, ye toh humne padhai nahi. How will we perform? So when you sit and study for first 10 minutes, just imagine you studying contracts. Take that time. It is okay. Out of 2 hours of studying, if you take out 10 minutes, just to imagine you starting from somewhere, believe me, you will get better output. You will actually study it rather than just postponing it for the other day. Then focus on the task at hand. Please don't be like, अभी ये पढ़ना है, एक घंटे बाद ये पढ़ना है, एक घंटे बाद मुझे खाना बनाना है, या I want to eat Maggie or I want to go Netflix. Don't do this. Whatever you are doing, be in the present moment. It is important. And if it is very difficult for you to center yourself in that moment, in that case, what you can do is take a deep breath, relax your shoulders, listen to one song, which will hardly take like 2-3 minutes. Come back to the present and then start studying. Please don't think about ye bhi karna hai, wo bhi karna hai, because if in 1 minute you are thinking ki I have to do 10 other things, believe me, you will end up doing nothing. Then before sleeping, every day make a schedule of things you have to do the next day. Make a priority list ki aaj 1 hour I have to give to studies, 1 hour I have to do something which I like, maybe learning something. Make a list like that and start with something which is extremely difficult for you, because once you are done with something extremely difficult, you will be motivated to finish easier tasks jaldi and in a better way. So it's good to have a list to know what you have to do next day. It will definitely help you. Now, so the other thing is that
Ma'am, I have a question. Ma'am, as you mentioned, you know, before, you know, ending your day, you should make your list that what are your priorities that you will be doing for the next day. Ma'am, don't you think so that, making list and, you know, pen downing all the tasks that you need to, focus on the next day. Ma'am, don't you think so this will ultimately give us more stress, because once we'll write down and we will be, reading that, it will ultimately give us some stress that, oh, we need to do so and so work tomorrow.
Okay, good question. But so stress, what we have, I've talked about earlier, is how you perceive it. So for in your case that you have said that you might just get stressed out by seeing itna kuch karna hai. I know many people who go through that. I myself, when I write things now, I'm like, itna sab kuch karna hai. But next day, when I start doing it and I give a tick or a star in front of the thing I have done, that happiness that I get is amazing. Yes, prior to that day, I was stressful that I have to do something. But next day, I knew I have to do these things. So no matter what, I will do it, because at the end of completing that task, I'm getting a star, which is a good incentive. So like you would remember when we were in KG or junior classes, our teachers used to give us a star on our cheeks when we did something good, or in our notebooks. And do you remember how happy it made us?
Yes, ma'am. I remember.
So that is the thing. The happier you are, more concentrated you will be, more motivated you would be. And before sleeping, if you write everything down, you are actually decluttering your brain, which is really important. Because when you are going off to sleep, you are on your bed. You are thinking ki ye bhi karna hai, wo bhi karna hai. You are thinking so much about it that you forget to sleep, which is also not a good thing, because sleeping is really important. But if you write it down, your brain will relax. You have taken everything out from your system. So recently only WHO had this slogan for Mental Health Day was talk it out. It's like that. You either talk it out or you either write it out. It's important. You are just venting it out on a piece of paper. It will help you. Initially, you will feel as a stress, but on the daily basis, when you start doing it, it is really important. More than that, apart from making a list, journalizing out of the context I'm talking, journalizing is really important. Every day writing. We used to write diaries when we were kids. I don't know how many of you did. I did. As a kid, I used to write diary. to just write how my day was, what did I do, if I had any fights or what I felt emotionally. But when you keep on writing it on daily basis, firstly, it improves your grammar. It improves your writing style. It makes you more creative. And it makes you relieved also, because there are so many things in our life that is going on. We cannot share it with people around us, with our friends or our family members. So in that case, what do? We need to take that out from a system, because the more you will suppress it, the more you will put it inside your head, there will be a day where you will not be able to take it and it will cause a lot of stress to you. That day is not a good day from my personal opinion. Okay, so...
Ma'am, may I add something to this?
Yeah.
Also, the point that this person mentioned, that it will give us stress if we note down everything. The things we are noting down before sleeping are the things that needs to be done the next day. They are important.
So yeah.
If we think that it will give us stress, so that is also a way, a kind of self-negative talk. Because yeah, that what we have written is important and needs to be done. And if we will think that it will give us stress, then problem is that we are again negative self-talking.
Yeah.
So we have to rather find a way to do it, not thinking that it will give us stress.
Exactly. True. I agree with you. It's true. It happens. So it's all about the way you talk to yourself is there. Again, out of the context point, most of the mental health issues, even depression, anxiety, starts with the way you talk to yourself and the way you perceive yourself. Because I don't know if you have seen this, but there has been a post where a cat in water is seeing herself as a tiger. So different perception. But what does it say? Is it positive or negative?
Negative. Oh, positive, positive.
Exactly. This is positive, right? So the way you see it is really important. If the cat would have seen itself as a mouse in that reflection, believe me, the entire day that cat wouldn't have even had a single piece of meal, because it would think that I'm not sufficient enough to even fetch a meal for myself. So anxiety, stress, depression, you feel worthless, you feel hopeless about things. This is what we want to avoid. And the first step is not having or not being harsh on yourself. Just remember, whenever you are being too harsh on yourself, stop, take a minute, think about your best friend and what you will advise them. This will definitely help you. Then,
ma'am, you're not audible to Miss Sanjana Singh. She is writing again and again.
Okay, just a second.
Please ask the team to figure it out.
Okay. Ashwini, is there any issue with the net?
Ma'am, your voice is properly audible.
Okay, so I think it's with her network only in that case.
Maybe the issue is with from the other side.
Yeah, I think it's with her only. So I'll just write it in the chat box in that case. Okay. I think it's already solved. Okay. So the second last thing I would want to put is when you start studying and you decide that you will sit and study for 2 hours straight, in that particular moment, please don't think about ki is 2 ghante mein itna sab karna hai. Because then you will be overwhelmed and you will not be putting your 100%. Instead of thinking ki mujhe itna sab karna hai 2 ghante mein, break it down into small parts which you can cover in next 2 hours. Rather than thinking ki ye sab karna hai, just think that I will do 2 chapters and that is it. And after that, I will take a break. Do things like that. And lastly, I would say that challenge yourself. Where when we are in a comfort zone, we never give our best. It is true. The more we challenge ourselves, the better we will do. So for example, if a person has to climb Mount Everest and he or she starts from the bottom, if the person will think about ki itna chadna hai ya fir itna bacha hai, yeah, keep, what if I die? What if I fall? This is not going to help you. But when the person is at the top and looking at the view, sun setting, sun rising, that is the feeling that we need to start our work with. if you guys are giving any competitive exam or if you're working in an office, then for office people, you can think about once you are done with the work, how you will feel. For people who are sitting for exam, once you crack that exam, you are in your favorite college, the college you've always dreamt of, how that would make you feel will keep you motivated towards your work. So yeah, so this is it about the session today. If you guys want to put across any point or anything, anyone wants to add anything?
Yes, ma'am. So, ma'am, when we are, you know, when we are working and, with work, we are also, managing our studies, like if we are preparing for any entrances. So, ma'am, that is the major issue. Why? Because we are actually managing our work and simultaneously we are managing our studies on the weekends. So, ma'am, there comes the time management issue.
Yeah.
So, ma'am, that has been the great, you know, that is the, the actual challenge when, you know, we face during that time.
Yes. Okay. So you want me to talk about time management?
Yes, ma'am. Little bit, if you could just brief it.
Okay.
Okay.
So first thing when it comes to time management is you have to make a schedule of things you want to or topics you want to cover in that particular day. Because you know that this is your syllabus. If you are preparing for anything, can you tell me so that I can explain you through an example?
Ma'am, I'm preparing for a 3-year LLB only and I'm working also.
Okay. So for 3-year LLB, so the syllabus is legal aptitude, English, then GK is there. So let's say on a Saturday, you want to sit and study. So in legal aptitude for, I think for 3-year LLB, constitution is really important. So what you can do is you can write what you have to study because constitution is vast. It's like they have so many topics to be covered. And more than that, paper is actually difficult for 3 years, as far as I know. So in that case, what you can do is you can start by writing things down that you have to do in that particular day. Maybe put constitution first because for me it's difficult. So I would put that. But for whatever is difficult for you, you can start with that. So things like that. That is the first step towards time management. So once you start preparing according to the time you have made, ki constitution ko 2 ghante dene hai, GK ko 2 ghante dene hai, you will be able to do better rather than thinking ki 2 ghante mein mujhe sab kuch padhna hai. Okay, so first step is that, like, write everything down, what you have to study, make a list out of it, and then start studying it. Make sure to take breaks while you are studying. Don't study in 2 hours ka stretch because your output would be minimum. So it's better you study for 40 minutes, take 5 hours ka break, 5 minutes ka break where you listen to something you want to listen to, you watch something, but don't add on to information that you already have. Do something that you've already done and something you enjoy, something old, something which you're familiar with. So zyada brain ko process nahi karna padega. So in that 5 minutes, take a good break. Don't think about what you have studied. Then again, 40 minutes ka stretch. So this is going to help you. And by the end of the day, you will revise, obviously, but you will also see that yes, it has helped you in certain way. You are able to memorize more, you are able to give more output. These are certain things. And if you are procrastinating on something, procrastination is normally associated with a negative feeling. So acknowledge that negative feeling and work towards it by reducing all the distractions that you have or by breaking down the task. And if in case you are studying for 40 minutes, in that 40 minutes, you get to get a call, which is urgent. So attend to that call, but make a plan, contingent plan. Ki if in 40 minutes, you're getting disturbed by something, then what will you and how will you cope up with it? So these are the few things that you can do. And apart from that, if you want, you can contact me. I will definitely help you with your studies and how to manage time further. So yeah, anyone else? So thank you so much for coming and I hope you like the session. In case if you want future sessions, just mail us or let us know. We will provide you with a slot. So bye. See you guys.